if that cat comes over here, I swanny. Welcome back to Let's Hear for the Boy. I'm Victoria and this is Washington, my service dog. Today we're going to be talking about the top 10 things you may or may not know about the ADA and service dogs and their handlers. Let's get to it.
Maybe he's no Romeo, but he's my loving one man show.
Service animals and their handlers are actually protected by the ADA, which is the Americans with a Disabilities Act, Title II. Service animals are not pets. They're not. They gotta work. So stop petting them in public. Okay? It is illegal to ask the person with a disability, "What is your disability?" It's illegal. So. Stop. Emotional support dogs are not service animals.
What?
Why? Under the U.S. federal law, comfort animals are defined as animals that are there for the person with disability by being there. They do not, by law, perform a task for a person with disability, and they're allowed in housing. So basically, what that means is any animal can be a comfort animal because it doesn't perform a specific task for a person with a disability. That's what separates comfort animals from service animals. A church actually have the right to deny your service animal. Fun little fact, I actually almost got turned down from going into a religious affiliation here in town. I went in, I had his harness on with Washington, my service dog, and they said, "I'm sorry, we can't allow dogs in here." And I was like, "Well, first of all, service dog. Hello? Service dog? Not dog. Service dog." Okay. I basically said, "Okay, well, I will not be able to worship here today because if he can't come with me, and if I can't use him during worship, I won't be able to worship here." So I started turning around, but thankfully someone else knew me already because I had been gone for a few years before I had gotten Washington my service dog. They were, you know, "Oh, no, wait, don't go. No, come back. It was fine. You actually have the option to train your own service animal. Now this can be a little tricky because there's tons of different types of service animals. There's service animals for the blind, service animals for the deaf, service animal for seizures, service animal for heart rate and blood sugar and all that good jazz, and also service animal for mobility. There's different types of service animals, and yes, you can train them if you want, but that comes with a cost. I train my own service animal. That would be him. If you know what you want, and if you feel like you can do it, and you have the time, and you have the effort, and you have the blood, and you have the sweats to do it. I think there are pros and cons to training your own service animal, and that's for another video because the list is way too long. I definitely don't regret training my service animal and putting all my putting all my time and effort. Our bond is so much stronger, it really is. So I'm grateful for him, and I'm grateful for the opportunity of training my own service dog. To distract your service dog from working. When you're out in Kroger, or you're out in Best Buy, or you're out in Walmart, or you're out in Publix, you get the picture, and you see a puppy that looks so irresistible. The one thing I know my fellow service animal handlers will agree with me. It's just not okay because it can distract a service animal from doing the work that it's supposed to do for their handler, for their disability. So when you distract them, you could cause some major issues. You may have triggered something and you just never know. Your service animal is always supposed to be there for their handler medically, physically, whatever they may be, and it could actually potentially cause physical bodily harm to the service animal's handler. So don't do it. It's just common courtesy. It could save the handler's life. I always like to think of it as Cesar Millan, the look, the touch, the eye contact. So just keep that in mind when you're out in public and you see a dog, even if it doesn't have a harness, you never know. I have some friends that actually have a service animal without a harness and they still are working. Service animals are actually legally allowed to ride in ride-sharing car services. So that can be from a taxi to an Uber to a Lyft. I work at a nonprofit organization. Some of the things I help with is actually information referral. I actually had this one lady call me up and she's like, are we legally allowed to allow, let them be in the car dogs? Like, they say it's a service animal. And I'm like, yes, ma'am. Cause she's like, and then she's like, I actually turned them down. You kind of broke the law there. And she's like, oh, you are? Yeah, you kind of have to let them ride with you. She wanted to learn, and I appreciate it when people want to learn when they make a mistake. And that's all she wanted to do. So if you want to become an Uber driver, a Lyft driver, a taxi driver, just be aware that you actually do have to allow service animals. So a handler can actually have more than one service animal at a time, if it serves a different purpose for the person with a disability. I think it's so cool. I love it. It makes me happy. And I would love to meet someone that has two service animals, and that I think that'd be just the coolest thing. I'm sorry, I just think that'd be so cool. And no, you cannot count as one as a comfort animal and one as a service animal doing something, because again, comfort animals are not service animals. This was just funny to me because I just think it's funny. Fear of animals and allergies to animals are not a legal reason to kick out a service animal of any business. So this is kind of interesting. I can tell you there's been a few times in his life, I was gonna say my life, but we haven't actually gotten kicked out because of allergies or fear of animals, but we have actually been asked to move at a different table at a restaurant. And I'm like, no, I'd like to sit there, please, thank you. No, I'm not, no, you move. So the US federal law does not actually cover service animals in training. Now wait, before you freak out. While this law is true, there are some state laws that actually do cover service animals in training. You just need to look into your laws, your state law. And yes, I do kind of understand why the ADA doesn't cover service dogs in training. Just because they're in training, anything could happen. They could have an accident. If you're anything like me, I brought out my service animal as soon as I got him because I wanted him to be able to be okay in church. I wanted him to be okay in meetings and when I was working. And I was like, it's okay. And it was. And I have never had an issue. And so you never know. I hope you enjoyed those facts. I'm so desperately sorry if you knew all of them. I was trying to be creative and I was trying to think of the ones that you may not know, but I'm so sorry if you did. Thank you for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe and share this video. And if you have any questions or just anything, leave them down below and I'd love to read them and I'd love to reply to them. So yeah, I really appreciate you guys. Oh, my dad would kill me that I just said it. So yeah, I really appreciate you all. And thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.